Your $19 monthly gift could mean the difference between life and death.
A CBS News investigation is raising questions about how the nation's oldest animal welfare charity is spending millions of dollars in donations.
I will be the answer.
The heartbreaking commercials are almost impossible to ignore. Sarah McLachlan singing to images of suffering animals and making an urgent appeal for donations to the ASPCA.
Will you be an angel for a helpless animal?
2019, the ASPCA CEO, Matt Bershadker, made more than $840,000. That's more than the CEO of the American Red Cross, a nonprofit 10 times bigger than the ASPCA.
We urgently need 3,000 new donors so we can rescue more animals.
Here at the ASPCA, we run only one shelter and are sitting on over $300 million in investments. Your donation can help pay our CEO nearly $1 million a year.
If you want to help pets, give to your local shelter, not the ASPCA.
Oh, they seem to be doing okay.
Hey guys, it's me, Comrade Lavender, here. Today I want to do the pure evil files of the ASPCA charity industry files, capitalism, true crime, manipulative commercials, etc. But before we get started, all my YouTube videos related to this topic right now will be linked down in the description down below, as well as on the screen right now, if you'd like to check them out. So let's get started into this anti-capitalism true crime deep dive video. Topic: the ASPCA has become a household name through its tear-jerking, emotionally manipulative commercials, showing images of abused dogs and cold shivering cats in distress, need of help, with Sarah McLachlan singing a sad song in the background, adding to more manipulation. After those iconic commercials debuted more than a decade ago, the ASPCA revenues tripled, going from $85 million in 2007 to nearly $280 million in 2019, making the ASPCA one of the nation's leading animal welfare charities. According to CEW, however, the ASPCA is focused more on enriching itself and pushing a radical political agenda than actually helping pets in need. And this is not surprising because charities are so bad, you know. I've exposed it in my other videos. The ASPCA gives 2% of its total budget to pet shelters while hoarding millions of dollars. This is why I support solidarity over charity. One of the country's most predominant animal rights and animal welfare charity groups is sitting on hundreds of millions of dollars, including millions in offshore Caribbean accounts. Giving out six-figure salaries to the employees and the CEO. The ASPCA CEO made $750,000 in 2018. According to a Charity Navigator study, the average nonprofit CEO's pay is $123,000. This means that the CEO's pay is more than six times the average nonprofit CEO, and it's on the top of Bershadker earning over $800,000 in the previous year. While only giving just about $2 to an explosive new report, for every dollar donated to the ASPCA, 38 cents was used to pay salaries and benefits. This is why I don't support charities, because it goes from top to bottom. It trickled down economics. And again, at the same time, according to the CEW, the ASPCA in 2021 had $390 million in revenue and $575 million in assets, including $310 million in investments and $105 million in savings. Perhaps the most striking of this, the animal welfare animal rights group has about $11 million in offshore bank accounts in the Caribbean, while tax filings show the ASPCA CEO, Matt, ranks in nearly $1 million a year, and 259 of his employees make six figures. When you start sharing this information with people, especially animal lovers who donated to this so-called charity, they're outraged, as they should be. There's a euthanasia crisis with more than a million animals killed, euthanized, in the U.S. every year. And you got this so-called charity group sitting on $300 million in investments. The ASPCA raised more than $2 billion for animal welfare since 2008. It spent $146 million, or about 7% of the total money raised, in grants to local animal welfare groups. Meanwhile, the group spent nearly three times that, at least $421 million, on fundraising. The CBS report also noted that the ASPCA didn't allow local independent societies for the prevention of cruelty to animals to use its donor list if the local humane societies include language that they were distant from the ASPCA and didn't receive support from the national organization. Critics have accused the ASPCA of fundraising at the expense of local animal welfare organizations. And in 2011, local SPCAs in California filed a complaint with the state attorney's general office alleging that the ASPCA engages in unfair and deceptive fundraising practices that hurt local SPCAs. The ASPCA denied it was making money off donors who confuse it with local SPCAs. Most people believe they're associated with all the local animal shelters, but they're not. In reality, they're not. This isn't the first time that the organization charity has come under scrutiny. In May 2019, 26 dogs died while the ASPCA charity was transporting them from Mississippi to Wisconsin. The group wasn't forthcoming about the details of the accident or incident, but according to the reports, the cause of death was most likely overheating. Years earlier, in 2009, the ASPCA rescued an abused dog named Oreo that had survived being thrown off a roof in Brooklyn, New York, nursing Oreo back to health and using her in the group's fundraising efforts. Oreo started to show signs of aggression when she recovered from her injuries. After a series of temperament tests, the charity decided to put her down. Pets Alive Animal Sanctuary offered to take Oreo into its care, but the charity refused the offer, ultimately euthanizing Oreo. The incident inspired the introduction of New York's Oreo's Law, which would have prevented shelters from euthanizing animals if a rescue group offered to take the animal under its care. Typical capitalist pigs, using people's emotions to make money for themselves under the disguise and facade of an animal charity that helps abused animals.